In this video, I'll tell you how I created this device to send simple messages to someone sitting in front of our TV. This is ESP8266-based device that sends notifications to LG Smart TV via Home Assistant running on our home server. In this case, I have a couple of saved messages defined in ESPHome, which can be sent using push buttons. This circuit is assembled on the custom prototyping board I made previously with this video's sponsor PCBWay.com. This board fulfills most common needs I have when it comes to prototyping boards, and I have made a video how you can design one matching your needs. When you need your own PCBs manufactured, I highly recommend PCBWay.com. If you are a movie enthusiast, watching something in home theater room, or maybe working from home and having a video call, you wouldn't want your roommate to walk in just to interrupt for non-important reason. I wanted to create a way to send simple, maybe pre-recorded messages to someone sitting in front of the TV without flashing the lights or playing sounds that could interrupt things too harshly. Me, my friends and family members who tinker with Home Assistant all have LG Smart TVs. The other day I noticed my Home Assistant had detected LG WebOS device, that's my TV. I checked what that integration can do, and there were some remote control things, but what I found interesting was this notifications section. After adding the automatically found device by following the instructions on the Home Assistant, I tried this notification service. In Home Assistant, I went to Developer Tools, Services, there I typed notify.lg and selected the only one service that popped up. The message to be shown on TV should be written on the message field. Clicking Call Service made that notification appear on the TV. The service name is needed later while creating the ESP Home configuration. I recommend copying it now and saving it somewhere for later. Next, I needed to connect switches to ESP8266 port and send different text notifications depending on which button was pressed. Button inputs can be configured with binary sensor component. Under the binary sensor, I have configured sensors using GPIO platform, enabling the pull-up resistor and inverting the signal, so the low is active state. In the on-press automation, I'm making an Home Assistant service call, and service to be called is notify dot with the service name copied in the previous step appended in the end. Message in the data section is the text that will be shown on the TV. I have copied that configuration 3 times to create 3 different switches with their own pin numbers, names, and specific text in the service calls. Okay, I'm editing this video and interrupting you because there's something I forgot to record previously. So you have to do one thing to make this work. In Home Assistant, go to Settings, Devices, ESP Home, and there in the devices, select the device we are configuring. So I have named it TV Doorbell. Click Configure and enable this allow the device to make Home Assistant service calls. Because if this is disabled, which it is by default, those service calls won't come to Home Assistant. Or the Home Assistant will show in the log they are not accepted. So make sure this is enabled, otherwise it won't work. In the hardware side, I'm using Wemos D1 Mini compatible board, one of my favorites, and I have 5V coming to the DC jack and directly to the 5V and ground pins of the Wemos board. Then I have 3 buttons connecting D2, D3 and D4 to ground when pressed. I have enabled internal pull-up resistors, so I don't need to add them to the board. Now this device can be installed outside of the home office or home theater room and used as some kind of doorbell system for notifying about different things without interrupting the video call or movie time. This was made for LG Smart TVs in specific, but there are some similar integrations for Samsung TV and Android TV based smart TVs. I don't have those devices, so I haven't tried the integrations either. If these notifications were a new feature for you, I hope your TV is supported. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.